Hello, hi, good morning, dear students. How are you all? This video lesson module number 9 on carbon and its compounds brought to you by Vignan Global Gen Schools, Hyderabad. I, myself, Venkat Reddy Peram, teaching faculty. My dear students, in the previous module, we have learnt about nomenclature of ketones, carboxylic acids, so that we are already end up all the families of carbon and its compounds or organic compounds. Today, let us learn more information about isomerism, functional groups, and homologous series. So, without delay, let us start the session. What is the first concept meant for today? Isomerism. What is that, my dear students? Isomerism. Isomerism. So, this is the first concept meant for this module discussion. Isomerism. Okay, so in this isomerism, see, we are already learnt about this isomerism in versatile character of carbon, versatile nature of carbon. But there we just learnt about definition. But in this module, we will learn total information about isomerism. Iso means same. What is the meaning of iso? Same. Meros means atoms. Meros means atoms or repeating units. So, iso means same. Meros means units. Same units. So, unit or atoms. For suppose, if you would like to understand this particular isomerism concept, let me explain with this, with the help of an example. So, let me take one best example from our families. What is that example? Now, let me take butane. Yes, butane. Do you know, my dear students, what is butane? Yes, butane is the fourth member of alkane family. Fourth member of alkane family with the molecular formula C4H10. Yes, C4H10. And in this butane, how many carbon atoms are there? 4 carbon atoms. Now, with this 4 carbon atoms, we are going to arrange these 4 carbon atoms in different formats, in different skeletons. Now, let us have a look about the skeleton. Now, let me explain about the first skeleton of butane, where all the 4 carbon atoms are in straight line like this. In between carbon to carbon, single covalent bond is present. Okay, so this is the first carbon skeleton. Is there any possibility to arrange this skeleton in a different way? By arranging carbon atoms differently? Yes. One more structure also possible. What is that? In spite of arranging all the 4 carbon atoms in straight line, let me arrange 3 carbon atoms in straight line where one carbon is attached to middle carbon atom in this way. One carbon is attached to second carbon atom in this way. So, later single covalent bonds. Okay, na? So, is there any difference in these skeletons? Did you find, my dear students, any difference in the skeletons? Yes. This is a straight chain. This is a branched chain. Long straight chain, branched chain. Yes. Now, after these two skeletons, if you observe, in every skeleton, carbon is tetravalent. You know already. You already learned this information from the previous modules. Carbon is tetravalent, whose valence is 4. So, carbon satisfied with 3 hydrogen atoms like this. And 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon satisfied. And even on second carbon also, 2 hydrogen valences are like this. Yes. Satisfied with the tetravalency. Yes. So, this is about first structure where all the carbon atoms are in straight line. That's why this is also called N-butane. What is the name of this first structure, my dear students? N-butane. Do you know the meaning of N? What do you understand by the symbol N? N means normal. Normal means all the carbon atoms are arranged in the same straight chain. Now, just to move on to the second type. Here also, carbon is tetravalent. It has the ability to form 4 bonds with hydrogens like this. Time to time, check whether it is satisfied with the tetravalency or not. Yes. But what is the difference between this first member and second member? First structure and second structure? Yes. Main difference is arrangement of carbon atoms or arrangement of carbon atoms or difference in the arrangement of atoms. Yes. Straight line branches. Now, what is the name given to this structure? This is called isobutane. So, on second carbon, there is a branch. That's why this position is called isobutane. Now, try to write the molecular formula of the first structure by counting the number of carbons and hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, C4, H10. Yes. C4H10 is the molecular formula for first structure. What is the molecular formula for second structure? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also 4 carbon atoms are there along with 10 hydrogens. So, molecular formula is same in both the structures. Number of carbon atoms are same in both the structures. Number of hydrogen atoms also same. So, what information do you want to conclude? These two structures are called, there is a special name in these carbon compounds. These two structures are called isomers. What name is given to these two structures, my dear students? Isomers. Isomers. Very, very important word. Isomers. And the phenomena is called isomerism. So, how to define isomerism? Compounds having the same molecular formula but to show different structural arrangement. Compounds having the same molecular formula but to show different structures are said to be isomers, and the phenomena is called isomerism. Okay, na? So, in this way, if you take butane exhibit 2 structural isomers. These 2 isomers are differentiate on the basis of structure. That's why these are called structural isomers. So, 2 structural isomers are possible for butane. But why structural isomers are not possible for propane, ethane and methane? In methane, 1 carbon atom is present. So, with 1 carbon, we are unable to arrange different structures. Good. Even in ethane, just 2 carbon atoms are present. With 2 carbon atoms also, we are unable to arrange different structures. And in propane, there are 3 carbon atoms. Even with these 3 carbon atoms also, different arrangements are not possible. That's why in alkanes, first 3 members does not exhibit the property of isomerism. So, fourth member onwards, this property exhibits. So butane has two structural isomers. What are they? N-butane, normal butane and isobutane. Okay, now my dear students. And now coming to isomers. What are the characteristic properties? Now, all isomers, first characteristic property. What is that? All isomers consisting of same number of carbon atoms and hydrogen atoms. All isomers possess same molecular formula. All isomers show similar chemical properties. Why? Because the composition is same. But isomers show gradation or variation in physical properties. Why? Why there should be some gradation, some variation in the physical properties means physical properties can be decided by number of different type of arrangements. Since structural difference is there, atoms are arranged differently, different arrangement of atoms are there, physical properties slightly varied, but chemical properties are same. Okay, na? So now let me write, what is the first characteristic property? Same molecular formula. Okay. Now what is the second one? Similar or same chemical properties. And third one, difference in physical properties. So this is about isomerism. Now if you take example 2, what is that? Pentane. What is the second one? Example pentane. Do you know pentane is the fifth member of alkane family with the molecular formula MFC5H12. Now let me see how many different arrangements are possible. Now in the first case, let me take all the 5 carbon atoms in the form of straight line where single bonds are present between the 2 carbon atoms. In the second case, in spite of 5 carbon atoms, let me take 4 carbon atoms in the form of straight line. On second carbon, there is a branch like this. In the third structure, in spite of 4 carbon atoms in straight line, let me take just 3 carbon atoms in the straight line like this. Just 3 carbon atoms in the straight line. On second carbon, let me take 2 branches. One is above the plane, second one is below the plane. And later, as you know, carbon is tetravalent. It has the ability to form 4 bonds and satisfied with tetravalency and with hydrogens like this. So that we will get the first member. My dear students, are you observing and following, Nana, everyone, strictly? So this is called N-pentane. So what is the name of the first structure, my dear students? N-pentane. Okay. Now coming to second structure, where carbon is tetravalent like this. Carbon to carbon single bonds. Yes. And remaining valences are meant for hydrogen. Like this. And what name is given to this structure where one branch is there on second carbon? This is also called isobutane. Isopentane. Yes. Now coming to the last structure, carbon is tetravalent. So carbon has the ability to form all the 4 bonds. Try to satisfy tetravalence and examine by taking like this. Now in this structure, what is the difference? On second carbon, there are 2 branches. And what name is given to this one? Neopentane. What is the name of this structural isomer? Neopentane. So in this way, pentane with molecular formula C5H12 exhibits 3 different carbon skeletons and 3 different carbon structures. 3 different structures. In the first structure, all the carbon atoms are in straight line called N-pentane. in the second structure, four carbons are in straight line. On second carbon, there is a branch called isopentane. And in the third structure, three carbon atoms are in straight line with two branches attached to second carbon. So all these structures differentiate on the basis of arrangement of atoms. Arrangement of atoms are different. That's why these are called structural isomers of pentane. So this is about a wonderful phenomena called isomerism. Okay, now my dear students. So this is about the first topic. What is that isomerism? Once again, compounds having the same molecular formula. Compounds having the same molecular formula, but show different structural arrangements are called isomers, and the phenomena is called isomerism. Now, after this isomerism, the very next concept I am going to teach, what is that means? Tell me, my dear students, any idea? After this isomerism, what is the next concept meant for this discussion? Functional group. Yes, what is that? Functional group. So, now before going to discuss about this, what is that? Functional groups. Let me ask few questions. So, what is the concept called? Functional groups. So this is about the concept. You know what is the meaning of group? Group means an atom or group of atoms. An atom or group of atoms. Yes. And what is meant by functional? Functional means special. Do you know what is the meaning of functional? Special. So this is comes under special properties. Functional means special properties. Because you know, every day you are coming to school, in general, school dress. Yes or no? And if you compare that dress with your co-friend, he is also wearing the same dress. So, that is called normal. But whenever you are attending for any birthday function, or marriage function, or any other functions, your dressing appearance, your attire entirely changed. Okay? And that means function. Functional means special. So when there is a function, your appearance and attire entirely changed. That means you are look like very smart and very special, like a guest. So here also same. And these functional groups, especially some groups are there in carbon compounds or carbon chemistry, which are known as functional groups. Now let me take one example to introduce this one. Yes. Now, let me take one of the best example to express my idea about functional group is ethane. Let me take ethane. Yes. So, ethane is the second member of alkane. Yes. What is the formula of ethane? What is the structural formula of ethane? One carbon, second carbon. Both are linked by single bond with three valencies are meant for hydrogen. So, hydrogen. Here, what is the functional group in this structure? The main functional group in this structure is, single covalent bond. What is that? Single covalent bond. This is the reaction site. And this single covalent bond only decides chemical properties of this ethane. That's why this single covalent bond is called functional group of alkanes. Okay, na? and remaining valences are shown like this. So this is the first example. And even for the second member, I am taking one more example for alkene family, ethene. What is that example, my dear? Ethene. So this is ethane and this is ethene. What is the structural formula? C double bond, whereas two hydrogens are attached to the first carbon in this manner and two hydrogens to second carbon in this manner. And what is the main functional group in ethene? Carbon to carbon double covalent bond. So this is the functional group, double covalent bond, and remaining two valences are meant for hydrogen atoms. So the properties of alkenes can be decided by this functional group. What is that? Double bond. Now coming to ethine. So ethine is the first member of alkyne with molecular formula C2H2, where carbon to carbon triple bond is present and remaining valences are meant for hydrogen like this. And this is the main reaction site and also called functional group, triple bond. Carbon to carbon, triple bond. And this triple bond can decide the chemical properties of ethyne. That's why this is called functional group. And now let us take alcohol, ethanol. Now let me take ethanol. Yes. In ethanol, two carbons, both are linked by single covalent bond with single bond OH group. And remaining valences are meant for hydrogen atoms like this. And in this ethanol, main functional group is this one. What is that? Single bond OH. And this group, this functional group is called an alcoholic functional group. What is the name of this functional group? Alcohol functional group. What is the alcohol functional group? Single bond OH. So this single bond OH can decide chemical properties of ethanol. And the remaining carbon chain decides physical properties. So carbon chain is dummy, functional group is mummy. Okay, na? So carbon chain decides physical properties and functional group decides chemical properties. Now in this functional group, there is a place for oxygen atom also. What is the oxygen? And this oxygen is called heteroatom. Heteroatom. So the chemical properties of ethanol can be decided by this heteroatom, that is called oxygen. Okay, na? And now coming to ethanol. The same second member, what is that? Ethanol, aldehyde. Now what is the formula? 1, 2. Double bond O, single bond H, single bond. Remaining three valences are meant for hydrogen atoms. Three valences, three hydrogens. And what is the main functional group in this ethanol? Yes, this one. So this is called functional group. What is that? Single bond CHO. And this is called functional group. What is the name of this functional group? Aldehydic. Aldehydic functional group. And this functional group decides the chemical properties of ethanol. And what is the name of this CHO functional group called, my dear students? Aldehyde. And in this aldehyde, O is present, that is called heteroatom. So that means, what is heteroatom? Atoms other than carbon and hydrogen present in the functional group are called heteroatoms. And the properties mainly decided by that heteroatom present in the functional group. Now coming to ethanoic acid. Yes, ethanoic acid. So what is the formula of ethanoic acid? CH3COOH, yes, two carbon atoms are present. In between two carbon atoms, there is a single bond. And on the second carbon, you need to substitute double bond OOH, COOH functional group. And remaining three valences are meant for hydrogens like this. Now in this structure, what is the main functional group? Carboxylic acid. What is that? Single bond COOH. And this is called functional group. This is also called carboxylic functional group or carboxylic acid functional group. And this functional group can mainly decide chemical properties of this ethanoic acid. Even in this functional group also heteroatoms are there in the form of oxygen, which decides the properties, chemical properties. Now coming to haloalkanes. Let me take chloroethane. What is that? Chloroethane. What is that? Chloroethane. 1, 2 carbons with single bond. So one hydrogen is replaced by chlorine group and remaining valences are meant for hydrogen in this way. Then you will get to chloroethane. This is called haloalkane since chlorine is a halogen. Now in this structure, main functional group is chloro. So the chemical properties of this entire molecule can be decided by chloro. So Cl is called functional group and Cl is called heteroatom. So because Cl is other than carbon and hydrogen only, which decides the chemical properties. Now coming to propanone. We are going to derive one ketone. Propanone, N-O-N-E. So three carbons are present. On second carbon there is a functional group, ketonic functional group. And remaining three valences are meant for hydrogen atoms like this. Yes. So this is about hydrogen atoms. And in this propanone, the main functional group is present is C double bond O with two free valences like this. C, single bond C, double bond O, single bond. This is called functional group. And what is the name of this functional group, my dear students? Ketonic functional group. And this is called halogen, especially chlorine, chloro. Okay, so all these are called various functional groups. Yes, once again, now let me take alkanes, single bond, functional group is single bond. In alkenes, functional group is double bond because this is the reaction site. In alkyne, functional group is triple bond. And in alcohols, single bond OH, aldehydes, single bond CHO, in carboxylic acids, single bond COOH, in chloroethane, haloalkanes, halogen atoms like chlorine, bromine, iodine, including fluorine. In ketones, functional group is single bond C, double bond O, single bond. This is called ketonic functional group. And in all these functional groups, if you observe, an heteroatom is present. What are heteroatoms? Heteroatoms are atoms other than carbon and hydrogen present in the functional group. Especially, what is the role played by these heteroatoms? These heteroatoms are present in the functional groups and specially meant for chemical properties and which can decide the chemical properties. So on the basis of these many examples, now we are going to define functional groups. What are functional group or what is meant by functional group? An atom or group of atoms. An atom or group of atoms which makes the organic molecule reactive and decides their chemical properties is called functional group. What is heteroatom? The atoms other than carbon and hydrogen. Where these heteroatoms are present? In the functional group itself and which decides chemical properties. So these functional group, whenever functional group is different and properties also different. That's why, you know, so whenever you are going to birthday function, you can celebrate cake cutting. Whenever you are attending for marriage function, you are influenced by band malam and baja bajantrilu. Yes or no? Like that, for every function, there are some rules. And here also, different functional groups are there. Their characteristic properties also different. Okay, now my dear students, hope everyone understood this functional group. And if you practice these functional groups in your daily life, then automatically you get mastery about that. No problem, because you try to work out all these things and put separate notebook. And seriously, if you go for written practice, means everyone will get all these functional groups. So that's all for today's class, my dear students, about isomerism and functional groups. Tomorrow we shall discuss about one of the very important and interesting topic, that is homologous series and characteristics. Till then, my dear students, have a nice day. Thank you.